Hey, welcome back to Rich Kids Online. We are so excited to be joining you from our Christmas studio here at River Ridge Church. I'm Louie.
And I'm Leanne.
And it's just great to have you back with us today.
In case you weren't here last week, we unveiled our monthly challenge for December here at Rich Kids Online.
Can you Christmas it? And it's December, so everyone's in a holiday mood, dreaming of Christmas cookies, hot chocolate, caroling, Christmas candy, and, you know, fun with your family.
We like to think of Rich Kids as our family, and we definitely want to have fun this morning. So I think we need to move on to the second week of our monthly challenge, Can You Christmas It?
Now I know you might be wondering, what exactly does that mean? And what it means is that we will be taking challenges all month long that have to do with things that we associate with December and Christmas. Last week we had a challenge called Can You Wrap It? And it involved beautifully wrapping Christmas gifts using only one hand. And I can't wait to see what challenge that Leanne's brought for us this week.
That's right. Well, last week was definitely a challenge and our gifts were kind of beautifully wrapped. But this year, we always look forward to decorating beautiful Christmas cookies and then eating them, right?
Yes.
So I thought that we could make our own beautiful cookies out of something new and different. Oh. So today's challenge is called Can You Cookie It? So, you know.
I love cookies.
Oh, I do too. But it takes a long time to like make the dough for cookies and roll it out and do all that kind of stuff and cut them out. So I thought maybe we could just do a shortcut and make cookies out of something different. So I know how much you love Pop-Tarts.
So I love cookies, Pop-Tarts, and shortcuts. So this is really shaping out to be the perfect experience.
Louis, this is your challenge.
Yes.
So what I thought was that we would each get a base.
Okay.
And then you can make your cookie however you want out of it.
Okay.
With some frosting and some sprinkles, and we'll have a minute. What do you think, a minute
to make them? Is it like the prettiest cookie wins or whoever eats the cookie first?
I think it's the prettiest cookie wins, but then afterwards you can eat it. So however you want to do it works for me.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Get set, go.
All right.
Oh, see, you don't even have to cook them.
That's right, that's what I was thinking.
They're even Christmas colors because they're strawberry.
I think so too.
Okay, and we're sharing.
You can do whatever you want to do.
Uh-oh, you're shaking the table quite a bit there.
Well, you know, I'm very serious about my Christmas cookies. That's all I got to say. Uh-oh, maybe this wasn't such a good
idea. This is the first cookie I've decorated this year.
Is it?
Yeah. Not the first cookie I've eaten, though.
I've eaten plenty of cookies. Have you eaten cookies already this year?
I don't ever not eat cookies. I mean, it doesn't have to be Christmas to eat cookies. I have not had a Christmas cookie yet, though.
I don't blame you. You know, I haven't had a Christmas cookie either, but I am really looking forward to eating this one.
No. Well, we'll see whose cookie looks better, and then we'll see whose cookie tastes better.
Well, yeah, well, you might get me on that one, I'm just gonna say.
Are we supposed to be doing two cookies or just one?
You can do whatever you want. This is your challenge. Perfect. You make it what you want. Okay.
I think we got about 10 seconds left.
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
Mm. Oh. I'm just going to eat this one, honestly. So I think you're going to win. I'm looking over at you. There's no chance for me.
So you're just going to eat instead?
No, I lied.
Okay. I don't think this one looks as pretty. But I get for trying to, you know, be a little artsy at the end.
All right. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4,
I think I'm done.
3, 2, 1.
Look, I got a star cookie.
I made a boat.
You made a boat?
Yeah, it's a...
The Christmas boat.
It's a Christmas boat. You know, in that Christmas movie where he's in the Arctic...
I never would have thought of that, Louie. Yeah, you definitely went outside the box. I just made the traditional Christmas tree and a star that, you know, goes on top.
Yeah, well, mine was more practical because you can use it to escape and to float away, but yours was prettier, so I think you won this one too.
Wow, I'm liking these December Christmas challenges. I'm doing pretty well. That is one sweet cookie.
That is. But you know what? I think that everybody came for a deeper reason than just watching us eat cookies.
I would agree, Louie. And, you know, why don't you just, like, finish eating your cookie, stop talking with your mouth full, and we'll watch maybe a video of our upcoming Bible story. Do you think we should do a review first of what we talked about last week?
I think we can do a review, and I got all the cookie out of my mouth
now. Okay, good. I'm glad.
In the Old Testament, God continually told his people, "One day I will send my son." God's people understood that a Messiah was coming, but they did not know when he would come. In today's Bible story, God sent an angel with a special announcement about when the Messiah would come.
So today's Bible story is called Angels Spoke to Mary and Joseph. Let's watch the video together.
One day, God sent an angel named Gabriel to a town called Nazareth. The angel went to visit a young virgin named Mary. She was engaged to be married to Joseph, a descendant of King David. The angel said to Mary, "Rejoice! You have found favor with God. He is with you." Mary was very afraid and puzzled. Why would God find favor with her? She had done nothing special. "Do not be afraid," the angel said. Then he told Mary that she was going to have a very special and unique baby, and they would call the baby Jesus, which means "The Lord saves." The angel explained that the baby would be great. He would be God's son. He would even be a king. The king God had promised would come. Mary asked the angel, "How can that happen? I am not married yet." The angel replied, "God will be the father of the baby. The baby will be God's son." Then the angel told Mary, "Nothing will be impossible with God." He said that Mary's relative Elizabeth was pregnant, even though she was old and did not have any children. "May everything happen just as you said," Mary replied. Then the angel left her. Mary hurried to her relative Elizabeth's house. When she arrived, the baby inside Elizabeth leaped for joy. The Holy Spirit filled Elizabeth and she said, "What an honor, Mary. Your baby will be blessed too." Mary was so happy. She praised God with a song about how great God is. Mary knew every family in the future would say she was blessed because God was going to do great things for her through Jesus. God was keeping his promise to bless the whole world through Jesus. Mary stayed with Elizabeth for 3 months. Then she went home. Now Joseph found out Mary was going to have a baby, but Joseph knew it was not his baby. Mary and Joseph were not married yet. Joseph decided to quietly break his engagement with Mary so she would not be publicly disgraced. Soon after Joseph thought these things, an angel appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph," the angel said, "don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because the baby she is carrying was put there by the Holy Spirit. Mary is going to have a son. Name him Jesus, because he is going to save his people from their sins." This happened just like the prophet said it would. "See, the virgin will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and they will name him Emmanuel," which is translated, "God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did exactly as the angel commanded. He married Mary. And when she had a son, Joseph named him Jesus. The baby Jesus fulfilled Isaiah's prophecy, as well as other Old Testament prophecies about the coming Savior. Through his life, death, and resurrection, Jesus fulfilled God's plan of redemption that God planned before the world began.
Hundreds of years after the prophets told of the Messiah's coming, in a town called Nazareth, God sent an angel to talk to Mary and Joseph, whom he had chosen to be Jesus's earthly parents. God sent angel Gabriel to talk to Mary. Would you be surprised if an angel appeared to you and started talking to you?
I would probably not only be surprised, but a little scared. Mary felt the same way. She had not done anything special to deserve God's favor, but the angel said God was happy with her and that she would have a baby, God's own son. That's pretty overwhelming. Mary knew it was an honor to be Jesus' mother, and she praised God.
When Joseph found out that Mary was going to have a baby, he didn't react the same way. He thought about canceling his plans to marry her, but then an angel spoke to him in a dream. The angel told Joseph that he should still marry her. He told him that the baby would be God's son, and the angel told Joseph to give the baby the name Jesus, which means God saves.
That is incredible. God's plan was happening. Jesus and Mary both listened to the angels and became husband and wife. And when the baby was born, they named him Jesus.
the baby Jesus fulfilled the Old Testament prophecies about a Savior coming. Jesus was born to rescue us from sin.
That definitely makes me want to praise God. I think this would be a great time for a worship song.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let her receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and heaven and nature. Glory to the King.
Well, I think we better wrap this one up. I, for one, have a great time with you this morning, and it's been awesome to study the Bible story with you.
Yes, and don't forget the Can You Cookie It today. I enjoyed our sweet challenge, and I can't wait to see you all back next week when we find out what we're going to attempt in our next monthly challenge, Can You Christmas It?
I'm definitely in. You know, maybe we could even eat some too. But before you go, you need to check in and see how all of you are doing on your Christmas devotional.
I've been working away on my devotional. I love learning more about the real reason we celebrate Christmas.
Yeah, I'm pretty pumped about it too. More than pretty pumped though, I'm super pumped.
Well, I think that's all the time we have for this week. How about I pray for us and we end our time together? Lord, I just thank you for today. I thank you for your plan to send a Savior for all of us. I thank you for the obedience and faith of Mary and Joseph to listen to your angels and to go and do what you told them to. Lord, I just most of all praise you and love you and ask that you be with us in this season. Help us to remember the reason that we celebrate Christmas. It's in your Son's name that we pray. Amen.
Amen. Hey, have a great day. Thanks
Bye,
for joining
guys.
Us.